Hey everybody, this is Jeff Dalton coming at you, another episode of CMMI TV. You know, clients sometimes ask me, what's the number one thing we have to be worried about in terms of failing in our project to improve processes using the CMMI? And usually what I say to them is, the number one thing you have to worry about is a failure of imagination. What do I mean by that? Well, a lot of times people read this book and they read literally the practices that are in the book. Things like establish a work breakdown structure and establish an organizational policy, they take those things literally. So let's take a look at what those two things are. A work breakdown structure is a list of tasks, a list of resources, a list of things that need to be done in a sequence that they need to be done in. A policy is something that tells people what it is they're supposed to do. More often than not, I'll walk into a client organization and they'll say, hey, let me show you our policies. And they pull a big binder off a shelf. It's filled with 22 chapters. Each one of those chapters is marked in the name of the process area of the CMMI. And there's a bunch of text in there about how they have to do these things or else they're not allowed to work there. And then at the very end of the document, there's a bunch of signatures on it that maybe the managers of the organization have signed. Problem is, when you talk to a lot of people in the organization, they have no idea that that book even exists. Same kind of goes for a work breakdown structure. A lot of projects will put together a massive Microsoft project work plan with list of all the tasks and everything sequenced with predecessors and resources and timelines and all the things associated with a traditional work breakdown structure, and they'll never use it. Why? Because maybe they're an agile shop and they're doing things in an iterative and incremental way that don't really require or encourage the use of such a tool. So I would say, have some imagination. A work breakdown structure is nothing more than a set of tasks, a set of sequences, and a set of resources. Why not take a Scrum shop and have a product backlog, a sprint backlog, user stories that are sequenced in some way? The content of those things equal the content of that work breakdown structure. So the way to use this model isn't to emulate what's in the model and emulate what's in the examples. It's to take what you're already doing and using the guidance that's in this book to help make what you're doing better. If you want to think of ways to make managing your product backlog better, take a look into the project planning and project monitoring and controlling sections of the CMMI book and interpret what's in that book to fit into your particular context. How about the policy question? Well, a binder signed by everybody sitting on a dusty shelf doesn't necessarily set the expectations for the organization, but other ways to do that might include having town hall meetings, having team meetings, and talking about these expectations as part of those daily stand-ups, or maybe having posters around the organization that say you must wear your badges, you must do these things in order to work at this establishment. So there's many different ways to go about setting expectations in the organization other than what's literally in the CMMI book that says have a policy. Policies are nothing more than a set of expectations. So as you're working through the improvement effort of your organization, make sure that you're doing things in an imaginative way that makes sense for your organization, not doing exactly what it says in the book. And that's everything for today. Thanks a lot.